have these really cute little popsicle earrings that I wanted to show you guys. I got them at Claire's and they were only a dollar and they're so cute. So today's video, I wanted to just talk to you guys about an idea that I had, and I wanted to sound you out and see what your thoughts were. So quite a few of you have asked about Kashi's rainforest cage as to whether I'm going to be keeping that theme indefinitely or if I'm ever going to change it up for holidays or do fun themes like I have in past. And I've pretty much already decided that I don't want to change up her main cage too often because it is a very large cage, which means that it would be a lot of work to change it. And I also feel like it would be too upsetting to Kashi with her personality that she has. She seems to like her little routine and to like things to be the way that she is familiar with. So for now anyway, but the idea that I had was that I could pull out my old DIY cage, which was 1,247 square inches. And that was a great size to do cage themes. It wasn't like too big or too small. And I could use that, I could set it up and perhaps let Kashi go explore in it on the night that I do decide to film the cage theme. It would be a little fun change for her without messing up her actual home and her routine and stuff like that. And maybe if she likes it, you know, I could film some clips of her playing in it and stuff like that. But that way it would be separate from her main cage and I could change it up as often as I want it and it wouldn't be upsetting to her, if that makes sense. Basically, I was wanting to ask you guys if that's something you'd be interested in. If you enjoy watching my cage theme videos, I could certainly do it in that cage. It's just that I don't want to change up her main cage. Now, as far as the tank behind me, that is the desert tank. And I had the thought that down the road I might possibly get a dwarf hamster. I don't know. The thing about a dwarf hamster is they do affect my allergies quite badly compared to a Syrian, so I'm not sure yet. I'll have to weigh that out, but it is a possibility, so I'm thinking I might keep that tank clean in case I do get a dwarf down the road, and then I won't have to like clean it again, if that makes sense. If you guys have any video ideas that you would like me to do that's like fun stuff, just let me know and I will see if I can try to film it. And I'll continue to keep you updated on Kashi as well. She is continuing to make progress with taming. She did so good the other night, and I wished that I was recording it. I wasn't recording it, but she actually was sitting on my hand and I had a chance to pet her and she didn't flinch like she usually does. And I was able to pet her for quite a while, so that was really awesome. But anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video here. And thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!